The Super Falcons are through to the quarterfinals and will face Cameroon on Thursday, 14th of July, after defeating Burundi 4-0 to finish with 6 points, finish second of the group. And yeah, I'm really excited about this victory for the Super Falcons. So in my match preview, I actually predicted that the Super Falcons were going to win 5-0. I was close again. Listen to what I said here. I see the Super Falcons of Nigeria defeating Burundi 5-0. Biggest ever prediction on my channel. I hope it comes to pass. And that's not all actually. I also said that Ajibade was going to score. In fact, I'm going to say that Ajibade would likely get a goal or an assist against Burundi. I feel like she's going to get a goal. Yeah, and she got an assist too as well. So I'm really excited about this performance from the girls. Wonderful display by the team. However, I'm still going to say, even though we won this game, there are still a lot of things to learn from this game. For example, our conversion rate has to improve. If you look at the statistics, you will see that we had a total of 26 shots in total. 11 of those shots were on target and we got 4 goals. In my opinion, getting 11 shots on target, we should be getting more goals. I'm sure the team will work on this going forward. At the quarterfinal stage, you should not make mistakes, because any mistake, you're out of the competition. Remember, only 4 teams will be qualifying to the 2023 FIFA Women's World Cup automatically. So Nigeria has to defeat Cameroon in the quarterfinals to advance to the semifinal and automatically qualify to the World Cup. If by some chance Nigeria loses the game against Cameroon, the only chance we would have is to play playoffs and hopefully qualify to the playoffs to the World Cup. But we don't want to go that route. We should try and win our next game. Wonderful display by a lot of the players today as well. Overall, wonderful performance by the team today. From the starting lineup, you could easily tell that these players did really well. The coach actually tweaked the starting lineup a bit. Nnadozie, of course, started in goal. Onome Ebi and Wale in defense still retain their position. We have Tony Payne and Nico Payne, the two sisters, playing the wings, starting in this game. Nico Payne got her first start for the tournament. In the midfield, we have Peace Efih, who got a goal. We have Uchebe, fantastic again today. And Okobi did really well as well. Ayinde could not come in at all in this game. In front, we have Ajibade, fantastic player. She got 2 assists, you know, and she got a goal. Woman of the match, in my opinion, if you ask me. Onumunu also started the game. She did not get a goal. She was stopped half time. But I think she had a decent performance as well. Uchenna Kanu, she got 2 goals. And she played really well, guys. In my opinion, Uchenna Kanu also deserved the woman of the match. But with Ajibade's performance, Ajibade definitely is my pick in this game. Burundi, you know, were disappointing, if you ask me. And it tells from the start as well. They had 4 shots in total. Only 2 of those shots were on target. They did not really come out to attack the Super Falcons in this game. I just saw the game now, so this is just my quick reaction. In my personal opinion, I feel like this team has a lot of depth. We have a lot of players in the squad. And the coach is lucky, because when you have players, substitutes like this, that can come in and also change games, you know, it's a really good thing. I was surprised that Odega did not start. I was surprised that she did not play. But I feel like the coach is resting them for the game against Cameroon. Ajibade also came off early. Onomebi also came off in the second half. So I feel like maybe the coach is resting them for the quarterfinals, looking at the fact that we've already secured the victory. Yeah, this is just what I think. What do you think, guys? Do you think we'll go for in this competition? Do you see us defeating Cameroon on Thursday and qualifying to the semifinals? Do you think our chances to win this tournament would also increase? Do you think we'll go for 10? Super Falcons, we count on you. Going for 10, so Super Falcons. I mean, the Super Falcons were fantastic today. They played really well, and every time I would always support them. I don't like to criticize the Super Falcons, because over the years they have proven their worth. Winning 9 tournaments out of the last 11 is no mean feat at all. It's not an easy feat to win 9 out of 11 tournaments. So I don't like to criticize the Super Falcons at all. Even if Super Falcons lose against Cameroon, me, I will not criticize them as a team. I'll probably just criticize the coach, you know. But for me, the whole team, I'm not going to criticize them. In my opinion, they have tried enough to deserve a bad tournament. However, there's still eye for this tournament. I feel like we can still go all the way. So I did a poll asking what you think the Super Falcons will finish at this 2022 WAFCON. And about 371 of you voted. 74% of you said we'll finish as champions yet again. 13% of you said we'll finish second. 7% of you said we'll finish third or fourth, that's playing third place. 4% said we'll finish in the quarterfinals. And 3% of you said we'll finish in the group stage. So far, 30% of you are wrong. And let's hope 71% of you are right at the end of the day. This is just my reaction after the game. Thanks for watching. Please, I want you guys to subscribe. Please get me to 50,000 subscribers before the end of next month. I really appreciate you guys. Thank you all for watching. Victor signing out. Hopefully, my next prediction, I'm right again, yet again. And yeah, the Super Falcons just defeated Burundi. We just defeated Burundi 4-0. Thank you, Super Falcons. You did us proud today. Peace out. God bless.